Gearbox Engineering, I'm Owen. In today's video we're looking at the box hood and looking at what all the levers and knobs do on the machine. Now when I first had a lathe and wasn't sure what the parts were called, I used to think of it as a horse. You have the headstock, the tailstock and the saddle. Now that might help you remember some of the parts. So let's go to the workshop and have a look. This is the Boxford lathe. What I want to do is explain what the levers and pulleys and buttons do and how it works. We'll start with the headstock. This is the headstock and that holds the chuck, the main spindle. So we'll start at the top here. This lever engages the back gear, and what that does is slows the chuck down depending on which position the lever is on this chart. If you put it in the A position, which is there, that would be running at a speed of 1400 RPM. So if you move the lever to the B position and put it on the smaller pulley, you'd be running at a speed of... Working further down, this hole is an access hole, so you can put oil can in there, and there is a oil hole right inside. You have to turn the spindle round to get it lined up with this hole, and then you can put the oil in. These two are grease nipples to get grease to the bearings. Some have caps where you put grease in a cap and it goes into the bearings. So if we move down, this is a spindle lock. So you turn, you can turn the chuck by hand without the lock, and then if you engage the lock, can use that so it holds the spindle still so you can take the chuck off. Now it's possible that that spindle lock will stick, so before you put any power in the motor on, make sure that the spindle lock is out, and by pushing the chuck back slightly it will spring out. Sometimes it will stick. So what have we got now? We've got this lever here, which if you pull it in, move it down, move it out, and that has changed the direction of the lead screw through the gears inside. So at the end of the headstock we have the gearbox, and there's a chart that comes with the Boxford lathe. I'm not going to go into thread cutting and gear changing. You rearrange the gears to suit the thread that you want to cut. It comes with another lot of gears, so you can swap these three main gears over on this one. These are fixed, these are for adjusting the forward and reverse of the lead screw. So if you want to cut a left or right hand thread, you just reverse it or run it normal. And depending on the layout of gears that you have, we'll cut the pitch that you need. If this is a metric lathe, so if you want to cut an imperial thread on this, you need to replace one of the gears, depends on what thread you're cutting, with the large conversion gear. So unless you're going to cut a lot of, in my case it would be imperial threads, if you've got an imperial lathe it'd be metric threads. This is interlocked, so it won't, your lathe won't start until the door's closed. And on the back here you've got the chart with the different gear positions. So by altering this lever, you will then alter the lead screw, not the chuck, just the lead screw, and the gears from the centre of the spindle that are in the train that drives this, you'll reverse them or put them forward, and that will have the effect of the traverse moving towards the chuck or away from the chuck, or even if you have the top slide, it will have it going backwards to the back or come to the front. We'll now go over to the bed of the lathe and work towards the tailstock. Okay, coming down on this side, this is your lead screw. Here it goes into the gearbox, and there's an oil nipple there to put the oil into this bush. The bed of the lathe goes from the end of the headstock to the far end of the lathe, and that'll be different lengths depending on what lathe you've got, and that guides the saddle and holds the lead screw in position. So coming on to this part now, this is the bed of the lathe which goes along to the end, and on the bed is the saddle. Below the top slide is the engagement lever for the traverse that lifts up, engages on the lead screw. So just engages the lead screw, disconnects the lead screw. Next to that is this lever. You pull the plunger out and you can move it down or up or in the middle. So the lever, when it's engaged, will let the traverse move, and you see it's moving along. To get the traverse to work on the top slide, you have to make sure that the lever here is not engaged on the lead screw. Let's move up to the tool post. So on here we have the compound slide, which can move backwards and forwards by hand, and you can rotate this as a protractor with degree markings around there, so you can rotate this at any angle up to 90 degrees. And then on top of that is your tool post. The center bolt goes through onto the T-nut underneath, so you can move the tool post whenever you wish. And also you have this spanner that goes on the tool holder, so you can take the tool holder off and change it for another one, and then tighten it up with a spanner again, and your tool goes in here, and this adjusts the height. Okay, that's the saddle. Now this front part with all the handles and knobs on is called the apron. So let's move back to the tailstock. This is the tailstock. You have a lever at the back under that, and you can push the tailstock backwards and forwards along the bed, and it locks it in the position that you want. This is the spindle lock. It locks the spindle from moving in and out when you've got the position you want. An oiler here. This is the barrel push there with a handle on the end, and you can turn it in and out. And inside there is a taper. In this case it's a number 2 Morse taper, and you can fit chucks, centres and other items in there. Then the casting here. Now on this one I have a grub screw at the front and back, so I can move the center line of the tailstock towards you or away, which is useful for taper turning. Further down is the other end of the lead screw with a block that holds it in position and another oiler there. And then if we go down to the bottom, this is your on-off switch for the power switch lathe on. This is the transformer for your low volt light. And this is your power for the motor for the headstock. So you've got forward, reverse, top and bottoms off. Oh well, that's it for the day. Hope you enjoyed it, hope it was useful, and we'll see you next time on Enoch's Engineering.